United States, members of Congress, the Supreme Court, all public officials who work for the common good, our armed forces everywhere, peacemakers throughout the world, may the Lord God remember his kingdom always, now and ever, and into ages of ages.
You and the Lord's of those gracious, may the Lord God remember in his kingdom always, now and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Christ is risen. Christos voskresi. Christe azgav.
Keshmari datavga.
Christos anesti.
Alihos anesti.
Christos anviat.
Alihos anviat.
Very good. Brothers and sisters, we just heard the gospel today. Lord Jesus heals the paralytic man. And if you listen to scripture before reading of the Acts of the Apostles, the same miracle Lord Jesus performed to the paralytic was performed by the Apostle Peter. And church communicates, putting those two together, communicates very strong message that Lord Jesus is present in the church. Miracles he did during his lifetime, restoring people to life, church continues to do after him, first generation, and now 2,000 years later, because the same Lord Jesus is present in the church. And paralytic man is cured, of course, there are always people in church who are not happy with anything, and they're not happy with the healing of the paralytic. They accuse Lord Jesus, they don't know who he is, but they are quickly to know which rubric he broke. And yes, it's not supposed to be done on Sabbath, carrying your stuff. And they don't care about the restoration of the loved person, but that's what a reaction of the synagogue is at the moment. Man restored to life, he is now a member of society, he supports himself, and it's done to him by Lord Jesus, because Old Testament religion and miracles which and God caring for people happening there were not able to help him. And we are today blessed and privileged to have Father Iona Zaimovsky serving with us from Danilovsky Monastery. And he is there, it's the oldest monastery in Moscow, and he is building a bridge between 12-step programs and the church. And that's very interesting history, that before the revolution, church in Russian Empire was very active in recovery, in sobriety. Sobriety societies, they called them, did have more than 500,000 people before revolution. And people would use all spiritual tools and were led by the priests. Specifically St. Petersburg, Father Rozhdestvensky, he was very active, and many other clergy. And so they tried to, Father John of Kronstadt, many names and saints who were addressing real needs of the people. Then what happened, of course, revolution, which killed this all. But then, you know, thanks God, 30 years later from that attempt, which our diocese was part of, Archbishop Tikhon Pelagin, he was a bishop here at the beginning of 20th century. 1904, he issues the decree ordering all his priests to open sobriety society in each parish of Orthodox America. So we did have 200 of them in 2004 opened. Then 30 years later, 12-step programs come. It's Alcoholics Anonymous appears from Dr. Bob and Bill Tokin. They cured from incurable disease, and they are establishing 12-step programs. And then church starts to kind of discern and struggle, accept, not accept them, how all this works. And it's continues now as we speak in many parts of the world, including Russia, because 12-step programs came there, and are they Orthodox or not? Is Orthodox person supposed to go to the meeting of Alcoholics Anonymous or Al-Anon or other? And so Father Iona builds the bridge. He built his own program, not to substitute and not to offer any kind of recovery, but to build a bridge between 12-step programs and the Orthodox Church, explaining priests here in education. He just got his PhD in November from a very good school in Moscow, and he is explaining to Orthodox clergy how to deal with families and people who are suffering. And he taught more than 500 Moscow priests as part of adult continued education for clergy about recovery, about 12 steps. He brought on his lectures, actually people from AA who told their stories, and that those are good efforts he makes and good results he achieved to familiarize. At the same time, to bring in people from 12-step programs into the church, because it's not one or another, it's one supplement another. So we will hear his presentation today, and I just, how does it concern me, you ask me, yes, why should we hear today about it in a sermon instead of, you know, talking about love and God and something sort of nice. Because each of us affected. Statistics show that 1 out of 10 people is alcoholic. Yeah? 70 million people opioid addicts in our country as we speak. So this is a member of your family, grandfather, father, maybe it's children, maybe it's your spouse. It's maybe your boss in your office. It's maybe your neighbor, but you know a few of them. And your life is not better because you know them, yeah? It affects us in the bad sense. And if you spend time with family with alcoholic or addict or in workplace or in other close relationships, you also acquire a disease which is called codependency, and which will kill you as effectively as alcoholism will kill alcoholic, or addiction will kill drug addict. So codependency is a big, big, big killer. It makes people unlovable, makes people trying to do good and to help suffering person, but without realizing they also need their own recovery, their own program, in order to become happy themselves, productive members of the society, and then help other people, versus run around and try to control the universe. So this is why we are talking about it, because it's a very real pastoral issue, and as we begin, Lord Jesus addressed to the man who was suffering, who was lying for 38 years there, at the Siloam, and old Testament church could not help him, but Lord Jesus could. And a very interesting detail, he remained anonymous while doing this. When we do something good, we should not ring the bells, and everybody looks at us. And Lord Jesus is present in the church, and apostolic church, and our church does the same service to suffering people. It's supposed to do it, supposed to do more of it, to help people in their real needs, to bring light of Christ in their lives, to change their lives, and make us sinners turn around, stop being self-centered, and go help other people. Christ is risen.
Indeed.
Christos Voskresi.
Christos Voskresi. Christos Voskresi.